Hello YouTube, CodeDismiss here, and this is a tutorial video on how to use the new PhatLoots info GUI feature. If you're unfamiliar with the info GUI, I'll provide a link to the other video I have explaining how to navigate that. But right now, this video, first of all, we'll make a new PhatLoot called vid. Actually, let me just do /loot info sample loot to kind of show you the info GUI. Just gives you basic information on the loot table. This loot table being sample loot, which is the one that comes with every PhatLoots install. The shows you how much money, how much experience, reset time, shows you all the loot. In this case, we have some collections that you can go inside of. And then you have all the items in there. But right now, we have a new PhatLoot called vid. And we're going to basically set this up. So right now, vid, you get nothing. But this new feature of PhatLoots makes it so you can set the entire loot tables up without any additional commands. You can do the entire thing with clicking in this GUI. So first of all, Let's change this money. Now, if you look over here, we have different tools now. We have a navigate move tool, and you can change the tool by clicking it, right or left click. Also, if you click outside here, it will change the tool. But we have three tools. What we want is the modify amount. This will modify the amount of a loot item, or in this case, the amount of experience or money. So if you left click, it modifies the amount. If you right click, it subtracts it. If you hold shift, it controls the upper range. And it's just easier to show you what I mean. So left click, left click, left click, going up by one each time. Double left click, went up by 10. And right-click, 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 right-click. That brings it back down. Now, if I hold shift and left-click, that brings up the upper range. So now we can do 9 through 14. Sorry about that. Did not expect rain. The forecast called for sunny skies all day. So, sorry for the interruption. Now, we have 9 through 14. We can hold shift and right-click to hold shift and right-click. Oh, I have to change my tool back. That's why it wasn't working. Hold shift and right-click to change that. Left-click to add it. Now, if I add or subtract without holding shift, it brings up the lower range and upper range, so it will always be 5 in between them. And you can do the same thing with experience. Show you that. And middle click sets it back to 0. So now we have 10 to 15 GP. So let's do /loot vid, and you'll see I looted 11. I'll loot again. I looted 14 that time. 14 again. And 15. And you'll see down here, I now have 54 GP. So, let's go back into the info GUI. And we can also, these are all toggleable settings. So we can change this to the modify probability and toggle tool. Probability is for loots, but we want to toggle the loot table settings, which you'll see is a scroll click. So we can scroll click this, you'll see the icon changes, and break and respawn sets to true. This chest will break after it is looted and respawn once it may be looted again. Click it again, changes it back to false. Chest will always be present. We can turn auto loot onto true or false. We can change the reset time from individual to global. What we can also do is go to modify amount, and we can change the reset time. So if you scroll click, that sets it to zero. And for this, because there's four numbers, all you can control is the hours, and if you hold shift, the minutes. And again, right click to, or left click to add, right click to subtract. So you can, using just the minutes and hours, you can get quite a bit of range of time. So that's why I only have it control those. We'll set that back to zero though by scroll clicking. Now, that shows you how to modify those simple settings, but what you're mainly going to do is you want to set up your actual loot that you get. I have items down here, so we'll use the navigate move tool, and at the bottom there, scroll click to add an item from the inventory. So scroll click, and to add all of these. They all set at default, probability 100%, and you get an amount of 1. The arrow, we don't want 1, that's boring, so we'll go to the modify amount tool, and we will change this to, we'll go to 40, and now hold shift to control the upper range, 40 to 65, 64 rather. So you'll get 40 to 64 arrows. We can also change the probability. Diamond sword, we don't want to show up all the time. So let's see here, this is a probability tool. We can decrease that. We can increase it, and if it goes over 100, it loops back around to 0. So we'll change that to like 50%. And also, we can change the amount of any other item. I'll just show you how that works. Too. You can see the number change right there and also in the description, and you can make it a range and scroll click to set it back to 1. So that's basically how you set up normal loots. Let's do slash loot vid to see what you get. All of these showed up at 100%. We got 44 arrows. The diamond sword only shows up half the time, so we didn't get that. If we do it again, then yeah, we do get it. And we got 56 arrows that time. So let's go back into, let's make it daytime first. There we go. Slash loot info vid. Now, these are all weapons. We only want them to get one weapon, so if you're familiar with collections, you know that you have to use a collection to make it so you only get one of these items and you always get one. So we can click this to add a new collection. And using the navigate move tool, first of all, we can hold shift and click these, right click, left click, and it will swap it with the item next to it. But or we can pick it up and place it inside the collection. So we're going to place all of these inside the collection. So this collection gives you a weapon. And if you look, you can right click to go back. If you look, number of loots 1. We can also change that by using the modify amount tool. We can make by right clicking. You can left click to add the amount of items that you get. Let me demonstrate this. /loot vid, you get one item. That time it was arrows. This time it was still arrows. Still arrows. That time a bow. Sword. And we can change this to, let's go to our modify amount. We'll change it so you get 3 loots. Depending on your config settings, you may get 2 of the same loots. That time we got 3 different swords. This time, bow and arrow and sword. That time, 2 swords and a bow. But how we want to set this up is 1. I just right-clicked there, which left the info GUI on accident. So modify amount tool, we can change this back to 1, or if you go down to 0, it says each loot is rolled for individually, and you'll see why you would want to do that in some cases in a second. So, number of loots 1. Let's change back to the navigate move tool, go inside here. Now we have all these items, let's just organize them a little bit more. Okay, so we have the bow and arrow and the 4 swords. We want either you get a sword or a bow and an arrow. So we'll add another collection. This one, we will put the bow and the arrows inside. So now you will either get one of these swords or the bow and arrow. But notice number of loots is set to 1, so you'll only get 1 of these items. We want you to get each of those items, so we'll set each of the probabilities to 100, which they are, and change this amount to 0, which does each loot is rolled for. We want to actually show that you can get just a sword or bow and arrow, so we're going to get rid of some of these other swords. Using the navigate move tool, you can scroll click to remove a loot. So we'll scroll click that and scroll click that. And then let's change these amounts so they actually make more sense. Half the time you will get a bow and arrow. Let's see here. 20% of the time you will get a diamond sword, and 30% of the time you will get a wooden sword. So, now let's loot that. You'll see that time we got a bow and arrow. That time we also got a bow and arrow. Bow and arrow. Diamond sword. Wooden sword. So you will see that that works exactly how we want it to. One last thing here is we can not only pick up items to move them inside the collection, but we can also right click while we're holding them to place them back outside the collection. So in this case, we can change this probability back up to 100. So we will get a wooden sword and one of those other items. Wooden sword and bow and arrow. Wooden sword and bow and arrow. Wooden sword and diamond sword. So, and by now it looks like I have a decent amount of money. Okay, so that is basically all I want to show you with this. I already said that you can scroll click an item to remove it. You can add a new collection. This added collection within a collection. remove the collection, go back to the top, so your navigate move tool, modify amount tool, modify probability and toggle tool. So this plugin update will be available on Bucket Dev shortly. You can also follow me on Twitter to receive an early link to the plugin release, and just try out this new feature because it will definitely make creating loot tables much easier. If you find any bugs, just let me know. This is kind of a beta feature right now, but I think I worked out all of the bugs out of it. Also, you can... Yeah, if you have any ideas for any way to improve this, new tools perhaps, just let me know, and hopefully we can get it added in there so we can make this plugin as easy to use as possible and do anything that you want it to do. So, that's all for now.